it's Janice Tuck here from the Fun Music Company, and today I've got a cool little worksheet and game for you which comes from our Music Theory Fun Sheets series. Now, Music Theory Fun Sheets are quick and enjoyable worksheets that are quite different from the run-of-the-mill theory worksheets like crosswords and finder words. One of the concepts that we've found that students really enjoy once they get into it, but they do take a little bit of time to get the hang of it, is our Treasure Island games. Now, this is a question that we often get asked, so I wanted to run through it today so that you don't get stuck when you give it to your classes. Well, firstly, the Treasure Island game has two components. The actual worksheet where the student completes the activity, and then there's the map page where the student goes and works out the answer to trivia questions. Now, to save on printing, we've made the map pages cover four worksheets for each series. For example, they can do rhythm level 1, 2, 3 and 4 with just one map page. Okay, so here's how to do it. Firstly, we need to do the worksheet. So question 1 is 2 beats for the half note, 1 for the quarter note, 1 for 2 eighth notes equals 4. Now let's write it in the box here. By the way, all our worksheets contain both European and American language options. So if you're more comfortable calling these minims and crotchets, then that's not going to be a problem. Now, I don't think I need to hold your hand to go through these simple beat sums. I'm sure your students will work them out pretty quickly if they know their notes and values. So I'm going to magically make them appear now. Now, in the next section, I need to first identify all those notes. Okay, so the first one is an A, and the second one is a middle C. The third one a C, and the last one G. So I'll just write them in. Then I get a direction out of this box here, and I also write that in the box alongside the note name. So the A is north, the middle C northwest, and the C east, and then the G west. I'll just save us all some time now to make the answers for 5 to 8 magically appear. Okay, so there we go. Now we go off to our map page with all that done. First, we have to find the starting point. So you find the skull that says level 1. As I said before, the same map page can be used for 3 other worksheets to save some printing, which is why there is more than one starting skull. Okay, so we look at the distance to travel from the note sums, question 1, which is 4 steps, and the direction, which is north. And then we get to the letter A, and we can write that down on the trivia below. Now, this is where people commonly get stuck, because for each question, you have to go back to the starting point each time. So we'll have a look at question 2, and it says 4 steps to northwest. So we move 4 steps to the northwest again from the starting point. And this time the result is K. Just doing one more, the third one is 3 steps to the east. So we get an E, and we transfer that to the answer. So there you have it. If you continue this process, should find out that the famous jazz clarinet player who is well known by his childhood nickname is Ackerbilk. The great thing about these is that once you get the hang of them, they're really very easy, and the students will enjoy picking up some great musical trivia along the way. There are 5 sets of 4 worksheets, so 20 worksheets that all use the same idea of the map page. But in them, they do work on scales, intervals, melody and oral as well as rhythm.
So I do hope you enjoy using these worksheets, and I've provided you with 2 worksheets below this video. One on rhythm, which is the one that you've just seen explained in this video, and the other one is on intervals. Now this, of course, is just the beginning. If you really want to extend your students, then you can get a whole series of worksheets using the same fun concept by checking out the link below. So go ahead, download them now, have a great day, and let me know how you get on.